Human prenatal development can be divided into three stages: pre-embryonic, embryonic, and fetal development. Fertilization usually occurs in the ampulla of fallopian tube. The fertilized egg, referred to as the conceptus at this stage, immediately travels toward the uterus. During the journey, it undergoes several mitotic cell divisions producing daughter cells called blastomeres. This process is known as cleavage because the cells divide without growing in volume. After about 3 days, the conceptus arrives in the uterus. It now contains about 16 cells and is called a morula. Cells of the morula are totipotent. They are capable of differentiating into all cell types, both embryonic and extraembryonic. The morula continues to divide while floating freely in the uterus for several more days. During this time, it consumes nutrients stored in the egg cytoplasm and uterine milk secreted by the endometrium. When there are about 100 cells, the cells start to arrange themselves around a fluid-filled cavity forming a blastocyst. The blastocyst consists of pluripotent inner cell mass called the embryoblast, destined to be the embryo, and an outer shell called the trophoblast, which nourishes the embryo. The trophoblast later becomes the chorion, the fetal portion of the placenta. The trophoblast secretes an enzyme that dissolves the membrane surrounding the conceptus, enabling it to hatch, ready to be implanted. At the end of the first week, the blastocyst becomes attached to the endometrium. At the site of contact, superficial cells of the trophoblast fuse together to form the syncytiotrophoblast, which grows into the endometrium and derives nutrition from it. The endometrium responds by growing over and eventually enveloping the blastocyst. The syncytiotrophoblast secretes the hormone named human chorionic gonadotropin, HCG, to instruct the corpus luteum to continue the production of progesterone. Progesterone is the hormone that maintains pregnancy. Among its many functions, progesterone stimulates the growth of nutrient-rich decidual cells to feed the early embryo. Around the middle of week 2, the embryoblast starts to form a two-layered embryonic disc, hypoblast and epiblast, at the midplane of blastocyst, with a cavity on either side. This bilaminar disc sets the dorsal ventral axis of the embryo, with the epiblast being the dorsal side. By the end of the second week, the two layers grow around the cavity on their respective side and form the yolk sac and amnion, respectively. The yolk sac provides nutrients absorbed from the trophoblast as well as gas exchange for the embryo during weeks 2 and 3 before the placenta takes over these functions at week 4. It is also the first site of embryonic blood cell production before the liver. In week 3, the two-layer disc transforms into three germ layers through the process of gastrulation, during which the cells lose their pluripotency and become committed to a smaller number of cell types. Gastrulation begins with the emergence of the primitive streak on epiblast surface. This event sets the cranial caudal or head-tail axis of the embryo. A so-called primitive node at the cranial end of primitive streak produces signaling factors that control the movement of cells. Epiblast cells migrate toward and through the primitive streak into the embryo. The first set of cells displaces the hypoblast and forms the endoderm. The second set of cells fills in the space between the endoderm and epiblast, creating the mesoderm. The remaining epiblast cells form the ectoderm. Each of the three germ layers differentiates to become different organs and tissues. All organ systems are present in their primitive form by the end of the embryonic period, but most of them are not yet functional or only partly functional. The yolk sac gives rise to the allantois, a primitive urinary bladder and part of the umbilical cord. The amnion grows to surround the embryo by week 4. It is filled with amniotic fluid, which protects the embryo from trauma and temperature fluctuations. The fluid also allows the fetus to move freely and prevent adhesion of body parts. The yolk sac, amnion, allantois, and chorion are the four embryonic membranes. Are you a fan of Alila Medical videos? If so, you will love our new Alila Academy. Based entirely on our highly effective animated mini lectures, our courses are designed to follow a typical syllabus in each subject. Each topic is extensively illustrated and comes with quizzes to test your understanding, downloadable PDFs for a quick review, as well as images for you to use in school projects or presentations. We are known for producing highly effective animated videos that explain the most difficult concepts in record time. We have no doubt that our courses will be a lifesaver for both students and teachers alike. So do come check them out. Alila Academy. Clear, concise, effective, with extensive visual resource. No one explains like Alila does.